Yesterday, I left the class at about in the inverse functions, inverse hyperbolic functions, and I gave you two assignments. Okay, today I'll start from this inverse hyperbolic functions as well. Yesterday I have shown you that sine H inverse X is equal to x plus root over x square plus 1, how it can be deduced. So what I did like this, let y is equal to sine h inverse x. So x is equal to sine h y, that is equal to e to the power y minus e to the power minus y by 2. And this is nothing but e to the power 2y minus 1 by 2 into e to the power y. So after cross multiplications, we have got e to the power y whole square minus 2x e to the power y minus 1, that is equal to 0. And solving this equation, we are getting these equations. So today I have given you to find out the cos h inverse x, and it is nothing but ln x plus root over x square minus 1. Okay. Now, you are given as an assignment, another assignment I have given, tan H inverse X is equal to, you have to find out the value. So the way you know how to do it, and if anybody get any problem, then please ask me in the WhatsApp. Then I left it for your practice. Do it slowly, but do it firmly. Okay. Now, properties of this inverse circular functions, I just drop it for today. I will do it next one. Then domain and range of this inverse circular functions is something difficult, so I will touch this one later on. Today I want to start the how to do the derivatives of this inverse circular functions. Okay, so today let us start derivative of hyperbolic functions. Hyperbolic functions. Okay, functions. So let d dx of sine hx. So you can easily find it out, d dx of e to the power x minus e to the power minus x divided by 2, and that is equal to d dx of half. You can take half common, and d dx of e to the power x minus, so you can write it down, d dx of, by using the algebra of the derivatives, minus d dx of e to the power minus x, and this you can easily do. Okay, so in this way you can find it out, the derivative of the all the functions. Okay. Now, I want to do some practice here. Okay. Let us find out the derivative of, just I am giving you derivative and values of the derivative. Okay. So, okay, let us take another page. Page 2. Say, approximate the following expressions for up to 4 decimal places. Okay, let cos h minus 2. Okay, that means cos h minus 2. Now we know that cos minus x is equal to how much? E to the power minus x plus e to the power minus 7 is a plus x divided by 2. Okay, so you can take common, so it is e to the power x minus e to the power minus x divided by 2. Okay, you know it. Now what about so is it equal to cos hx? Is it equal to cos hx? No. So surely I have made some mistake. So what about this? First you do cos hx is how much? E to the power x plus e to the power minus x by 2. So now make it x as negative. So this is nothing but e to the power minus x plus e to the power x divided by 2. It is even same. So cos h minus x. So by placing x, replacing x with minus x, you remain, this is nothing but cos h x. So here, this is nothing but cos h 2. And this is nothing but e square plus e to the power minus 2 divided by 2. And the result, you will find it. Okay. In this way, you have to find out the result. Okay. And using your calculator, and you will find the result is 3.7622. Use calculator. Now, all of you know how to use this calculator? Respond me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So by using this, you can do this in this way. Okay. Now, I want to show you one more example. Okay, let cos I is the IY is equal to prove, you have to prove it, cos HY. This is an expression. You have to prove it. Okay. You know that how to do it. You know that cos x is how much? Cos x is how much? E to the power ix plus e to the power minus ix divided by 2. Now check it. All of you check in your notebook. What is there? E to the power ix is cos x plus I sin x. And e to the power minus ix is cos x minus I sin x. So just put it and add it, you will get cos x. I presume that all of you know e to the power ix is equal to cos x plus I sin x. I presume. Because that is included in your high secondary syllabus or class 11 syllabus. I don't know exactly, but it is there. So we can use this expression. Now put x is equal to iy. Okay. Put x is equal to iy. Then cos iy that is equal to just here. E to the power I square x प्लस ई टू द पावर माइनस आई स्क्वायर एक्स डिवाइडेड बाय टू, दैट इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच, सॉरी आई स्क्वायर वाई, इट शुड बी वाई, इट शुड बी वाई, इट शुड बी ई टू द पावर आई स्क्वायर वाई प्लस ई टू द पावर माइनस आई स्क्वायर वाई डिवाइडेड बाई टू आई स्क्वायर. सो हाउ मच इट इज, आई स्क्वायर वैल्यू यू नो, माइनस आई स्क्वायर वैल्यू यू नो, सो पुट इट एंड यू विल गेट द रिजल्ट. ओके, सो इन दिस वे बाई यूजिंग योर प्रीवियस नॉलेज यू कैन डू इट नाउ. सो रिमेंबर दिस, हाउ टू कन्वर्ट इट फ्रॉम द, that is I Y to H Y. This is a very good relationships, and then you can find out what is sine I Y, then what is tan I Y, and so on, all the functions, cosec I Y, cot H, cot I Y, and in this way, in terms of, there is I Y has been expressed in terms of hyperbolic functions. IY has been expressed, that is some imaginary cos of some imaginary number has been expressed in terms of hyperbolic functions. The utility of this is that cos of some imaginary number, this is an imaginary number, has been expressed in terms of hyperbolic y. So how to convert it, you can now do it. Okay, now in the third page I am using, okay, I want to prove one important proof, one important result. Sine hx plus cos hx to the power n, to the power n, that is equal to sine hnx plus cos hnx. You can put one bracket here everywhere before h, always you can put here also, you can put some bracket. Okay, now this you have to prove. So we shall prove by induction method. I think all of you know induction method. Induction method. Okay. Let you can write it down. Let Pn, P capital N, Pn is equal to this expression, the whole expression. Okay, that is the statement. Okay, Pn is equal to sine hx plus cos hx to the power n. So Pn is a statement, so is equivalent to, this is equal to sine hnx plus cos hnx. Okay, now don't bother, you have, I am just pronouncing each term only because of this, that I am using an electronic pen, so h and n may sometimes may become equal, x and n may become sometimes equal, but you just do it. Now Pn, so this is a statement, this is called a statement. Yes, statement. Now for n is equal to 1, if we put n is equal to 1, so p1 is equal to, you see, I just put it 1 and here 1, here 1, so it is true. So pn is true, isn't it? P1 is true. Okay, now let, so for n is equal to 1, p1 is true, that means this statement, this relationship is correct. Now this way of writing is done in the logic. in logic. So let us suppose that Pn is, let us suppose, I am not writing let us suppose, but you must write, let us suppose that Pn is true for n is equal to k, for n is equal to k, and k belongs to the natural number set n, and k must be greater than 1. Okay, so this is true for Pn is true for n is equal to k. What is k? K is a natural number and it must be greater than 1. So Pn, so Pk is equal to or equivalent to sine h x plus cos h x to the power k, that is equal to sine h k x plus cos h k x. Okay, so this is true. Now this is true, this statement is true. So let, if this is true, then sine hx plus cos hx to the power k plus 1, that is equal to, now you write down the expression, sin hx is equal to e to the power kx minus e to the power minus kx divided by 2 plus cos hx, cos hkx e to the power kx plus e to the power minus kx divided by 2 and multiplied by e to the power x minus e to the power minus x divided by 2 plus e to the power x plus e to the power minus x divided by 2. Okay, now you just calculate this one, you just do yourself. We don't know whether this expression is true or false, but this expression is true. We have supposed, okay? If this expression is true, as we have supposed, then this must come in this form, okay? So you just calculate it. Multiply this with this, then multiply this with this, then multiply this with this, and then multiply this with this, and do the calculations yourself, and you will see the result will be nothing but e to the power kx into e to the power x. After doing so many calculations, you will find this will be the result. Okay, now check it yourself. You can check it at home also, but it will come like this. So this is nothing but e to the power k plus 1 x, okay, k plus 1 x, and that is e to the power k plus 1 x, and you know this is nothing but sine h k plus 1 x plus cos h k plus 1 x. E to the power x, in the beginning class I have written e to the power x is equal to some even function plus some odd function. That even function was cos hyperbolic x and odd function was sine hyperbolic x. So e to the power k plus 1 x is nothing but this two, and this is of this form. Check this two. In place of k, it has become k plus 1 only difference. And so this function, that is power k plus 1, is in the same form as k. Now, if this is supposed to be true, then pk plus 1, this is nothing but pk plus 1. If I use this one here, so okay, we just drop this one here. Here, this p k plus 1 is equivalent to this equals to this. That means if we suppose that if this statement is true, then this statement is true. Now put k is equal to 2. So if k is equal to 2, then if k is equal to 2 is true, then p3 is true. If p3 is true, then p4 is true. And we have seen that p1 is true. So if p1 is true, if p1 is true, then p2 is true. Then if p2 is true, then p3 is true, and so on. So for all natural numbers, the statement is true for all n, provided n belongs to the natural number set. Okay. So this is n. This is called the induction method of proof, and this is one of the easiest method that has been used in mathematics for, say, for 500 years. Okay. Now, let me go to the fourth page. Now, derivative you have, so you can do the derivative. Okay, I am just placing now one derivative before you. So, find out the derivative of log cos hx. Okay, let y is equal to log hx. So find out ddx of y. So do as usual. So what is the derivative of log x? You know, 1 by x. So ddx of y is equal to 1 by cos hx into ddx of cos hx. Now you know how to find out this cos hx. So you just put it here and you will multiply it by, and again you can use the expression for cos hx here, and here you will get the expressions. So in this way, just simplify to the definitive form of cos hx, sin hx, come to this and do the derivative as you know it. Okay. Now you can ask me questions. If there is any questions, you can do it. Now, for 5 minutes, question answers. You can do the question, ask me the questions. I will answer here. Anyone? No questions. Do you have questions? Hello? Questions, if there is any questions, you can ask me. No questions, I think. There should be some questions. I presume that you know the derivatives of the elementary functions. Elementary functions means e to the power x, log x, then sin x, cos x, tan hx, tan secx, then all logarithmic functions, all known functions, that is polynomials, you know how to do the expressions. And you should know the expressions of like this, x plus root over x square plus 1, say y is equal to x plus root over x square plus 1 or x square minus 1, then d, what is dy dx? You should know how to calculate this one. Okay, so derivative you can do it. Okay, just evaluate. I'm just give you just one. I'm showing you just one. Say cos H inverse sine H inverse X. Okay, say y is equal to like this. So what is dy dx? What is dy dx? So y is equal to like this. So let how to do it. Find dy dx. You have to find it for these functions. Cos H inverse sine, in the argument part, sine H inverse X. Okay. So let y is equal to this. So what will happen? Put x is equal to sine h u. Okay. So what will be y? Y is equal to cos h inverse bracket. This will be nothing but u. That is sine H inverse of, in place of X, sine H U. Okay. And this is nothing but cos H inverse U. Okay. So dy, find out dy du. From here you can easily find out dy du, because H inverse U, you know that is nothing but you have to sum, you have to do, you should know it now. What is the value of this? Log of U plus root over U square minus 1. Okay, so you got it. So dy du, you got it, and you will get it result as 1 by root over U square minus 1. Okay. And you must find dx du, dx du from here. From here, you will get dx du. And what is the result? That is nothing but cos h u. So dy dx is equal to dy du into du dx. Just from here and from here, you will get the result. And then use your this part. What happened? Use this part, so you'll get the result. So answer will be, I'm just writing down the answer. Answer, you just check it, root over sine H inverse X whole square, sine H inverse X whole square minus 1. And this is in the second bracket, multiplied by 1 plus x square with a root over. Okay, this will be the answer. So those who knows the chain rule of differentiation in the higher secondary syllabus, it is there. That is very easy. So you have to do it in this way. If there is any trouble, ask me now. If there is any trouble, ask me now. No trouble, not of anyone. This is sine H inverse X, inverse X. Okay, so let it write it nicely. 1 by root over sine H inverse X whole square minus 1 into root over 1 plus X square. This is under this one sign. Okay, this will be the result. So in this way, you have to do the one is log with log, and another is both inverse hyperbolic functions. So this is about how to do the derivatives. Now, tomorrow I will discuss about, not tomorrow, I will let you know the time afterwards. Now, let me hide the board. Is there any questions? No questions? Is there any questions? I am asking you for questions. I am not giving you any assignment today, but I want to help you to find out the yesterday's assignment. You can ask me if you find any problem, but you have to draw the graph what I have given yesterday. Okay, just you see the graph. You see the graph. Graph paper আঁকবে. Now you have to use the graph paper. So the y is equal to, I am just helping you, sine h x. So you use your graph paper. Use graph paper. Okay. Use calculator. I have given that take x is equal to minus 10 to 10. Okay, so there were, and take say minus 10, then minus 9, minus 8, minus 7, and so on up to 10. So you will get 20 points. Is not it? So first point is say y is equal to sine h minus 10. You use your calculator, you will get the result something. Take two decimal places value. So in your graph paper, you choose the center as 00, okay, as 00, and you choose the unit and put this according to your will comfortably using use comfortably. That means suppose your result is something, but you are using say 5 square, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as unit 1. Okay, so you just draw the graph so that it looks nice and you are comfortable. It should look like this. This way, and here it will come this way. Okay, it should go like this, not in this curved manner. It will go smoothly. Okay, it will go smoothly, just like this. This board, because I am drawing on a electronic board, that's why it becomes so wavy. But it should come like this here. It should look like the sine hx sine, and there will be 20 points like this. 20 points, you will get the points here. This must be done and send to me. Okay. You should submit all the assignments by today is 17th, by 23rd, 12:20. Okay, these six assignments you do yourself, but it should look nice and everything. But those who have sent it, who already done it, can send me beforehand. Okay, can send me beforehand. This is very important, because the shape of the curve is very important. You must know. Then, if you are interested, you will write cos hx. Okay, cos hx. Now you choose your points. Now these points I shall not tell you, but choose your points. I will give it today. I am not giving. First you get some experience over it here, and then I will give it. And from this you can easily find out the domain. Now see, this is x, is not it? And this is y. You see, as x goes to this side, this function goes to this side, so it is minus infinity to infinity. And from here, y also goes to infinity, and this is minus infinity. So I have told you that sine hx for x is minus infinity domain, and range is also minus infinity. But for cos hx, this will not be like so. So you choose the points, you will get that cot hx is always lies between 1 to infinity. That means it is always positive. So it should like this. It should like this. It will come down here at 1, then again it will go up. Like this. It should come like this. Okay. So you will draw it. So for negative values, you will get something unusual. For negative values, you will get something. For x negative values, it will go on increasing, but it will never come like this. So similarly for tan hx, you can do it. So this will help you to make you understand the domain and range of the of any functions. Like this also, inverse circular functions, inverse functions, inverse hyperbolic functions. So this is about your, I'm just going deeper into the deeper. Next day, you just practice. Now for practice, I am asking you to derivatives of all the, find out the derivative of all the trigonometry hyperbolic functions, as well as all the inverse hyperbolic functions. First you do this job. Okay, but these are not assignments. Assignments I will give you tomorrow, next, in the next class. Today I want to stop it now here. Okay, any questions? You can ask me any questions. All the trigonometric hyperbolic functions as well. Okay, any questions? No questions. So
sir, please show all these slides again, one
okay.
by one.
Okay, sine h inverse x is log x, this, then derivative. I just started with derivative. No, this is yesterday. Up to this yesterday, I told you. But now today it is how to derivative, how to derive these expressions. Just I recapitulate. Now the derivative of hyperbolic functions. Actually, it starts from here. Actually, it starts from here. Here, this one. It starts from here. So derivative, you have to calculate in this way. Now this derivative and this derivative is known to you, so you can do it easily. Next thing is that page 2. Now I have told yesterday I have not given you any example of how to calculate the value of some cos hyperbolic x, because it is required for to find out the value. But you are using calculator, so actually it comes out in this way, square minus in this way. Okay, and here I have used this expressions. This cos of hyperbolic minus x is equal to cos hx, and here is another example, cos iy. That means this is a complex number. You can express this cos of a complex number with the help of this hyperbolic number, hyperbolic functions in this way. So you can find out sin iy, then tan iy also. Now I have given one theorem. Actually, in complex number, you will write here it is ix and this de Moivre's theorem. But here also hyperbolic, this is also like this. So I have used induction method to prove this one. I think you have understood it. If you don't understood, tell me. I'll repeat it in the next day. Then, how to find out the derivative? I have given two examples. I have done it. Okay, using this direct, using this chain method of doing differentiations. Then in the 4, I have just given again. This is very important. This part is very important. This drawing of the curve is very important. I will first see whether the graph is there, and then I will not see other assignments. If it is not there, I shall not consider the other assignments. This is about your today's class. Understood it, I think. Okay, then. Do you have any questions? You can do it now. Okay, then I just stop recording. Yes, stop recording.